Good evening, everyone. My name is Terry Sullivan, and this, once again tonight, is the Inside Corner. And the topic this evening is an individual. One might say a pioneering individual. Not an oddity. Don't get that impression anywhere tonight as you listen to this show. The topic is Riley Frisbie, pioneer. Why? Well, just recently, in fact, less than a week ago, Riley is the first female Lyons Township High School student to play baseball, ordinarily called boys baseball, at Lyons Township High School. It is, in a sense, a kind of groundbreaking event, but it also has a whole lot of sociological impact on the sports scene at Lyons Township High School. Once again, Riley Frisbie, the first girl to make the boys' baseball team at Lyons Township High School, ever. Do you understand? Okay, now don't you think that's a pretty interesting topic? You want to know, how could that possibly be? Well, we'll find out, and you'll get to know a whole lot about her. And in a short period of time, we are indeed also going to interview her father, Sean, a Lyons Township High School graduate, and her mom, Katie, who is also a Lyons Township High School graduate. And we're going to get their perspectives on what this means to them, to their daughter, and to their family. So, there you have it. Yes, not an oddity. What's the word? It's not odd, it's remarkable. Do you feel as though you have accomplished something odd or something remarkable?
Remarkable.
Yeah? But you've done it in other places, in other settings.
Yeah.
Yes, like where? Tell me where. Tell me where you were the only girl.
The only girl on the Grange All-Stars for baseball.
Little League All-Stars.
Little League.
Yes.
And then on my past travel team, Western Springs Tigers. And I also played football in fifth and sixth grade at my...
You did?
At St. Cletus.
At St. Cletus. Mm. And you were the first girl ever to play football.
No, I was the second girl.
Second girl.
There was a girl grade above me that I played with for 2 years.
What was her name, by the way?
Caroline Hurley.
Really? Did she go to LT?
No, she goes to St. Ignatius.
Oh, she did. Did she play any so-called boy sports?
No. She was really tiny.
Okay. So you are still this singular individual. It's a remarkable thing. Even though this topic is my idea, now that I'm sitting across from you, it's amazing. It's amazing. That you have, first, that you have the abilities which surpass most of the boys. And I give you that appraisal because that's, you know, I have a little leeway there because this is what I do a lot of. I kind of appraise people and their baseball talents. And I saw you practice the other day, and there's no doubt in my mind that you're better than at least 50% of the boys on that team. There's no doubt. But what does that earn you, you know? So you are better than 50% of the boys. Is that what you're after?
No.
What are you after?
Just to play the sport I love.
The one you love the most. Of course, you could be playing girls softball. And you do play girls softball.
Yeah, I played girls softball the past 3 years, along with baseball.
Mm-hmm. So the question becomes, are you going to make a choice somewhere along the line? Are you going to choose softball or baseball? Are you going to have to separate the two?
That's still a debating topic. Okay. I love baseball, but softball might be the better decision later.
How so?
Better way to get a scholarship.
Scholarship, yeah. The holy grail of the scholarship.
Yep.
Maybe it is. Maybe it is. And, you know, you're thinking in those practical terms, it might be the easier route to a college scholarship. So, okay, so it's your first day of practice at LT. Freshman baseball team, and there, let's say there are 50 people in the 50 boys. And there you are. And what is anybody saying? Anything?
There's no one saying anything bad. It was all good. I was really surprised. I thought there'd be at least one or two people, but most of the kids were really nice about it and mm-hmm. just were encouraging me.
Like what? Encouragement? Like what?
During like batting practice, they're all like standing around just encouraging me whenever.
Yeah. Dumbfounded, more like it.
Yeah.
Yeah. Whoa, what am I doing here? They must be saying to themselves. Uh-oh,
There's one position on the team taken up is what they must be thinking. That's one less for me. At any other time, in any other setting, where you were the only girl, did you encounter any resistance?
Yes.
Don't mention names.
I won't.
But did you describe the situation?
It was during a baseball tournament over the summer, and we had a doubleheader, and I was catching the first game, and there's a team sitting behind us that we were playing the next game. And like the entire time, I wasn't really paying attention to them, but my coach got really into it because he was really big about like defending me about boys doing that. They were just saying like, oh, she's a girl, we're definitely going to beat them, we're going to slaughter them. And it ended up really good because he ended up putting me to pitch against them, and yes. I did really well against them, and they stopped talking.
Okay. So did you close out that game?
No, I started.
You started the game.
Mm.
All right, so you have run into some harassment,
yes.
So mild, moderate mm-hmm. harassment. No one's ever physically threatened you?
No.
No. This is good. At least people's minds are open enough not to be that crazy, not that rude. No bullying. You've never been bullied. This is good. This is a vote for humanity. That people, you know, youngsters are maybe open, but probably youngsters are much more open-minded about this possibility than the adults. Okay, so your first day out for baseball, did you feel as though you were in some sort of freakish experiment? Did you feel that? Did anyone ever? No.
No.
Because you have confidence in yourself.
Yes.
All right. I don't mean to use the word freakish. I mean freakish in this sense, low incidence. Low incidence. How many girls are there in the nation that are going to be playing high school baseball for boys, you know? That's what I mean. Really freaky that there should be this one incident and it happens to be in Lyons Township High School. So you didn't feel like an experiment?
No.
What did you feel?
I just felt, I don't really know, like, the feeling. I just felt kind of normal because I knew most of the boys on this team just playing against them in the
past.
Did
you survey the group and say, yeah, I belong here, or yes, or no, I don't belong?
Yes.
You did.
Mm-hmm.
Did you say, well, I'm better than that guy?
No,
you didn't do that. And so when you did appraise the situation, the setting, what was your thinking?
I was mostly just thinking about, like, at first I was thinking about, like, the whole, like, harassment thing, if they're going to take it the wrong way or if they're going to encourage
yes.
me on.
Okay. Have any girls ever said anything to you about being on the boys' team?
A lot of the softball girls asking why I'm not playing with them.
Right, because they, but only because they want you.
Yeah.
To add to the quality of the girls' softball team.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. And the adults say you should be out for softball.
Some wonder why, but, mm-hmm. and some coaches.
And they've approached, and adults have approached you?
Yes.
Coaches?
A couple.
Really? And what are the questions?
Just why baseball?
Why are you doing this? Why are you, is it in the tone of why are you causing this controversy? Or why didn't you choose the sport of softball? Which? Why are you creating this controversy? Was that the tone?
No, more just like, why would you try out for baseball more and like, why do you like the sport more than softball?
Okay. Anyone come to you with any legal issue about you should
not
be out,
I
you
remember.
Can't be out for baseball?
Well,
legally.
There's been like, no, I don't think so.
Because are you familiar with this guideline in the IHSA, wherein if the female has an equivalent sport opportunity, she should be out for that sport,
mm-hmm.
not the boy sport. Are you familiar with this?
Yes.
Yes. The same thing if a guy was to go out for, what, girls' gymnastics as opposed to boys' gymnastics.
Mm-hmm.
They'd say, hey, you have a place. It's over here.
Yes.
Okay, so no adult ever tried to use the guideline against
you. No adults have.
No. No one at LT ever said.
Just like students just wondering, like since you're playing baseball.
This is really healthy. No adult at LT ever said to you, you can't go out for boys baseball. You have an opportunity for softball. That's your opportunity.
They never said, like, they never told me, like, I couldn't. They just wondered why.
Why? Yes. And I think it's a positive amazement.
Mm-hmm.
It's like, whoa, why are you doing this when you could be so good at softball? But they don't know that you can also be so good at boys baseball. Again, please trust my opinion a little bit, okay? Yeah. Okay, so what position are you going to play?
I tried out for catcher, pitcher, and third, but I've played every position besides shortstop or second. So. Mm-hmm.
Where do you feel most comfortable?
Pitching or catching.
Pitching or catching. Okay. Do you have brothers?
Yes, I have an older brother.
You do? Mm. And did he play Little League? And
yes.
All that?
He played freshman year at LT.
He did?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. What is he? Is he playing baseball now?
No.
He's not. Okay. Did you and he, in a sense, play together as kids and kind of grow together in the sport together?
Yes.
Okay, so if he were still out, you and he would be, you'd be on the freshman team, he'd be on the sophomore team. This would be really neat. Is he playing another sport?
He just plays golf now, but not at LT.
Okay, he's golfing. Okay. Any rivalry between the two of you?
No.
About sports? No?
Not anymore.
No? Do you want to tell people his name while we're here?
Shane Frisbie.
So Shane, if you're watching, and you will be watching, I'm sure. This is a remarkable thing. I think you probably miss having her around in the same sport, the same season, but there are golf scholarships too. Okay, so do you feel, again, I'm going to come back to this more and more and more, because I think people watching want to know. Do you feel as though you're some sort of special attraction, and does it make you uncomfortable?
Sometimes it does make me uncomfortable. I rather just like play the sport and not be like just about it.
Look, I've asked you to be here on this show, and there's a potential for 9 suburbs to see this. So I'm kind of making a special attraction out of you. But I have seen you play, and that has told me this is the right topic, because she can flat out play. Okay? She can really play. This isn't an experiment. The coach might have even been, he might have been about the business of trying to attract her over to boys baseball from softball. So the justification is you are fully qualified. This isn't an experiment. Well, what is it going to lead to? Where's it going? Tell me, where do you want to go with it?
Just keep playing until, like, it all depends on, like, what happens, like, in my seasons, like, depending on how well I do.
Yeah. You mentioned the scholarship earlier.
Mm-hmm. If something goes wrong, and there's been girls that I've played with before, or that are on the older teams that I played for, that played baseball and got softball scholarships.
Yeah. And we should, at this point in time, you and I have discussed the other girl who was involved in this same scenario. Her name was Jennifer Hartman. She's a chiropractor here in LaGrange now. Hello, Jennifer, if you see this. Good to see you again. She would have been the first Riley Frisbie, but ironically, the last day of the cuts for varsity baseball at Lyons Township High School, Jennifer decided to go back to softball. And she did earn a scholarship, college scholarship for softball. So you are then, without a doubt, the only girl ever to make the boys baseball team in LT. And LT is a school that's over 100 years old. I mean, this is pretty good. There was an era where they wouldn't allow you to do this.
Yeah.
Right? Yeah. It's a barbaric era. It's a past, thank God. It's long gone. Do you see yourself, you might be a coach one day?
Probably.
Yeah.
Just if I keep loving the sport like I do now, then definitely
coaching
yes.
baseball.
Yes.
Yeah. And you might be the first of that kind, too. You might be the first female high school baseball coach. In our area, I've known of another. Wow. So the season will start your freshman year. The first game
is Monday.
Is this coming Monday?
Yes.
Who are we playing?
I don't know.
Okay. And do you expect to be in the starting lineup? What do you think?
Hopefully.
You think there's a chance?
Yes.
I wouldn't be the least bit surprised that you'd be in this. And when you this is putting a lot of pressure on you, but nonetheless, this is history, and we have to explain it. We have to give the viewer the benefit of the doubt that they want to know the historic aspect of this. The historic aspect is that when you step foot in that batter's box, the first game of your freshman year, you will indeed then be, without a doubt, the first girl ever to do that. Yeah, no pressure though. No pressure. Don't worry about it. That first pitch in the batter's box will be a history for Lyons Township High School. Do you understand?
Yes.
Yeah. It will be history. Whether you hit the ball out of the park, strike out, get hit by a pitch, doesn't matter. That first pitch will be Lyons Township High School history. A school, a school that graduated its first class in 1888.
Oh my gosh.
You will be the first lady to be an official member of the boys, and there has been a boys baseball team every year since the school opened. You will be the first one ever. Yes. It's a remarkable thing. Yeah. And you, I don't think it's sinking in until now, this moment. Yeah.
Not really.
It's sinking in now. It's a wonderful thing. And again, it is by no means a token decision. She is without a doubt qualified. Yeah. So what, tell me your equipment choices. What brand glove you wearing?
The glove I use in the field's a Wilson glove. It's an A2000. It was actually my brother's when he was a freshman.
It was your brother's glove, yeah?
And then he stopped playing and I got
it. Okay. And your bat?
A Dean Marini. It's a
Dean Marini.
New edition one.
When we come back after this break, your dad's going to join us, and we're going to get his reaction to your participation, and if he ever saw this coming, because there are parents out there who would want to know, wow, what would it be like if our daughter got involved in this, and maybe our daughter should be involved in this. There'll be parents asking that question, but then the both of you can tell everyone watching about your experiences in travel baseball, where you played on an all-girls baseball team and traveled to Canada and Cooperstown, New York, and played there. So, again, my name is Terry Sullivan, and this is the Inside Corner. The topic this evening is boys baseball pioneer. Yes, I guess that's what we'll have the category, is boys baseball. But it's really the first female boys baseball. How does that make any sense? This is the first girl ever to play boys baseball at Lyons Township High School officially. Her name is Riley Frisbie, and we'll be back with her and her dad in just a minute. Please come back. You're watching Channel 99 LTTV.
To order a DVD copy of any LTTV program, call us at 708-579-6407 or log on to our website at lttvonline.com. Follow the directions and submit your order. LTTV, welcome home.
Hey everyone, thanks for coming back. Again, my name is Terry Sullivan and this is the Inside Corner. We happen to be in one of our regular settings. This is Blueberry Hill Breakfast Cafe at the corner of LaGrange Road and Harris Street. And we're here only because of the generosity of the ownership, namely Chris Manolis. Okay, so the topic this evening is Riley Frisbie. Do you know her? Well, I think you're going to get to know her better this evening by watching us, but I think you're going to get to know the name. It's the media is going to latch onto it and cause her some stress, as we are this evening. But you may know her in other positive categories. You may get to know this name. Here's the significance of the name for you this evening, having never met her. Riley Frisbie is the first girl ever to make the boys' baseball team at Lyons Township High School. Now, this is the same baseball program that in recent years has won two state championships, innumerable conference championships. It is probably the premier baseball program in the state of Illinois, and it has been that for about the last 25 years, when you measure the program by its number of appearances in the state finals, conference championships, college scholarships. So we're talking about a girl who makes the boys baseball team in a very, very strong and prestigious program. Why? Because they need the publicity? No. Why? Because they want to show everyone that they're really fair? No. She made the baseball team at Lyons Township High School because she was better than most of the boys who went out for baseball. How do I know that? As I watched, and I'm convinced of it. In fact, I'm convinced that not only is she qualified to make the team, and not only is she more capable and talented than some of the boys on the baseball team, but she has what we call in baseball upside. There's more to come. There's potential. So, when she steps foot in the batter's box for the freshman baseball team, and I'm predicting she's probably going to start that ball game, but when she steps foot in that batter's box, whenever that might be, Monday is their first game, she will be making Lyons Township High School history and history in the Lyons Township area. She'll be the first girl to make the boys' baseball team and play in an official sanctioned IHSA athletic event. Wow. Here she is right here. And next to her is her dad, Sean Frisbie, a 1986 graduate of, as you can see, he has come proudly displaying that he's a Lions dad. He's been a Lions dad for a while, and her mom has been a Lions mom for a while. And we're going to meet her in next segment. But, okay, so, I don't know. Things change, huh, Sean? I mean, yeah. Things change, by the way, incidentally, just by coincidence, Sean, when I was the baseball coach at Lyons Township High School, Sean played on my team and was one of our mainstays, very important to the team. So he knows a little bit about baseball. And I'm wondering when he watched his daughter improve and continue to improve, what was going through your mind?
I don't know, it's been, you know, kind of a crazy ride.
Yeah.
You know, it seems like there's always been a couple doubters, you know, as she's gone through the ranks from T-ball to Little League. And I guess, you know, I was always, you know, I'm her dad, so I always thought differently, but try not to say it, you know, because as we talked before, that we're trying not to make it a novelty thing. Mm-hmm. She just wants to play.
Right.
And so, you know, we kind of always expected her to compete, you know, because she's worked very hard, you know, not just at games or practices. She also goes to special trainers and works out at two different locations and then also has a physical trainer too. Mm-hmm. So, I mean, we've been preparing, like, but it's something she's always loved.
Okay. Preparing in the baseball category?
In the baseball category.
Yeah, because she's been playing softball simultaneously.
Correct.
So, and they are kind of, there are differences. There are big differences.
Oh, they always say there is, but I always said if you can't go from hitting a 9-inch baseball to a 12-inch softball, then we are in trouble.
Yeah. Okay, so you've had a hand in her preparation.
A little bit.
Yeah.
Just try not to be too much.
Yeah, right.
I'm trying to step back more and more.
Yeah.
All right.
And now you'll have to.
Right.
Because now she's in the so-called scholastic organized situation where the coach is a teacher and you don't have much say about anything anymore.
Right.
Right. So you're going to have to step back. What do you think, what are you predicting? Is she going to do all right? This? You think she'll do all right? She going to hold her own?
I think so.
Yeah, I think you're right.
I think with all the training and her commitment to it, you know, this is her passion. This is what she loves. So there is no choice of failure. It's always about competing and being better and getting better.
Okay, but let me get back to I want to get back to this. The point in time, can you remember the point in time at which you were watching her doing whatever it was, T-ball or maybe even before that in the backyard when you were playing catch with her. The point in time when you said, whoa, wait a minute here. She's advanced. Was there that point, that realization time?
I think so, probably when her 9-year-old all-star, it was kind of like an in-house all-star thing for the 9-year-olds, and she was pitching and struck out the first three kids, so it's kind of like, hey.
Struck out the first three boys.
First three boys, right. Yeah, she was the only girl there also.
Yeah.
So she struck out the first three boys and kind of said, hey, I think we got something
there. Yeah, right. Which one was it? Was it pride? Was it fright because of the responsibility? Was it pride Or was it fright that now I've got the responsibility to help her fulfill her objectives because she has this talent. I don't want her to waste it. Which was it?
Pride.
Was it more so? It was pride.
Pride.
Yeah, pride.
I mean, because we always knew that there was other things that she could do right. If this didn't work out.
Okay,
so
healthy. Excellent.
It was, hey.
Excellent. Great answer. That's a good answer.
Nice
yeah. job. Well, know what he just said there? He is not living through you. Yeah. Yeah. I was worried, but he is not living through you. And that is really crucial. He's got to stay out of it. He knows that. Yeah. This is for you. This is about you, for you, whatever you want to do. You want to quit tomorrow?
Can we do something else?
Yeah. Play the violin. Right? It's good attitude. That's good parenting. Yeah. Proud of that. For your sake. All right. But here but nonetheless, it's going to be constant management. Because look what I've done to you. I brought you on television. And there are going to be people watching this, and they're going to identify her now. And the word's going to get around. Hey, they got this girl over there. And are you going to be able to... what I'm saying, this becomes another management problem for you and Mom, for Katie. Another management problem. To keep the healthy distance. You know, you allowed me to do this, but what if local ABC or CBS steps into the scene, or ESPN, or somebody like that?
I think we'd probably take it on a per account basis, because we don't want it to be a circus, a novelty.
Yeah, right.
And we don't want her to have to worry about that stuff. We just want her to play, and that's what she wants to
just
do.
Just to play. Yeah, because playing is where the growth takes place.
Right.
You don't want to interfere with the growth. By the way, before I forget, the audience shouldn't get the impression that there have never been girls out for boys' sports at LT. There have been girls out for sports at Lyons Township High School in the past. Several have been out for boys' wrestling. The difference is between those girls and Riley is that wrestling is a no-cut sport. Do you understand? Anybody who came out for the sport made the team. And since there wasn't an alternative, a girl's alternative to wrestling, the girls are allowed to try out. But it was no cut. In Riley's case, she's trying out for a boys' sport, wherein there is a girl's alternative, and LT has allowed her to play boys' baseball. And it is a cut sport. She was evaluated, and she remained. Do you understand the difference? She had to make the team. The girls out for wrestling did not have to make the team. They made it simply because they were students at Lyons Township High School. So this is beyond wholesale acceptance. She had to show she was qualified. And that makes it historic. All right. So the travel. It's expensive. The travel teams.
Yes.
All right.
It's very expensive. And
it's burdensome on the family. And how many summers did you do that?
She's played travel for 3 summers, but this past summer was probably the most expensive.
Yeah, I won't ask you how much, but you know, when you're spending money on your kids, it's not as painful.
Right.
So the Canada trip, they went to Canada and they played in the tournament, which was for girls baseball teams only, correct?
Yes.
Right, it was the Canadian Bantam Championships, where they were the first American team to play.
And they were the first American team to play. Which town was it played in?
It was in Nova Scotia.
Oh, way up there.
Yes.
Wow. Beautiful scenery, too, by the way. Okay, so there are evidently a lot of girls around the nation who would like to play boys baseball. So you get up there, and the competition is pretty good?
Yeah, it was really good. It was, I believe it was 17U, so there's a lot of older girls. I was one of the
17 and under?
Yes.
So you were one of the youngest girls on the...
Well, there's actually an 11-year-old on our team.
Oh, there was?
Yes.
Wow. She in our in the LT district?
No.
Okay. I'm asking this question because this is where you meet other fathers, not only the ones on Riley's team, but you get to observe other fathers and what kind of relationship they have with their daughters who are playing in this all-male dominated area.
Right.
What did you see?
Well, actually, I didn't make the Canada trip.
Okay.
I made the Cooperstown trip.
Okay, same
deal. Same thing.
So you get to Cooperstown, New York, same deal, except this time they're playing against boys.
Right.
Cooperstown. Was there another girls team there?
There wasn't an all-girls team, but there was one girl that was playing on a boys team.
Was your mom with you in Canada?
Yes.
Okay, we'll talk to her about Canada. So you go to Cooperstown,
yes,
for a tournament, and there was another girls team.
No, it was an all-boys team, just one girl played on it.
Okay. So, but your team
was all girls.
It was the only all girls team.
First all girls
team. In a virtual all boys tournament.
Yes.
Did you encounter the father of the other girl who was on a team in the tournament?
Yes. You did? Actually, that girl came and spent the night with our girls.
Yeah, she
figured as much. I figured as much. And how did that, how did you gravitate to each other?
Our coach saw her playing, and our coach is really into going and finding other girls to play. And she's actually playing for our team now.
Is she?
Yes.
Where's she from?
Maryland, I think.
Okay, describe this guy for me.
Very, just like all the other dads that like us, very supportive, very tolerant. Would be good because there were some New York teams that weren't real happy that there were girls there. But really, a super nice guy. We went out with him a couple nights and he ate dinner with us a couple times. So, very similar to what we were going through.
Mm-hmm.
You find that everybody kind of has the same problems and same experiences going through it together.
Okay, now when Riley's probably so embedded in this sport that she's not, when I asked her before if she had any experienced any negativity from adults, the kids are involved in the game and they're playing, they're so entrenched and focused, so to speak. But adults aren't. Adults see what other adults are thinking and doing. Did you run into some jerks?
Yes.
Yeah.
Big jerks. And they were actually from Illinois. Unbelievable.
Of course. Wisconsin would believe that. So what, they might say anything to you?
Oh, they said something to the girls. I wasn't actually standing there when it happened, because I probably would have got kicked out.
Yeah.
But after I think we beat them 11-1. And one of their dads was telling the girls they should go back to softball, and we're thinking, what are your kids going to do?
Your boys should go back to softball.
Right. So it was
11-1. You beat an all-boys team.
It was in the middle of the game. One of the girls was pitching and struck out something. He just started yelling at us and was like, "You should play softball, not baseball."
Well, we adults know what that was all about. Yeah. Well, that isn't that bad. And they were from Illinois.
Yeah, they were from Illinois.
Chicago area.
Yeah.
So you might encounter these people again.
Those kids won't go as far as we're hoping to go.
Yeah. All right. So what do you expect? What are you gonna expect?
I told Riley we would evaluate every year, and if we have a good year, then we can continue. If not, then we need to make that decision: do we stop baseball and go to softball?
Softball. For practical reasons.
For practical reasons. Like you said, the Holy Grail is getting a scholarship.
Yeah, come on.
I want to retire someday.
Not only that, you have to think of it in these terms. She is deserving. Let's put it this way. At that point in time, we hope her to be deserving of the scholarship.
Right.
That she progresses in the sport and is accomplished. And if that's the case, then she deserves the scholarship. It's not like you're chasing it.
No.
And you're coveting it. You're just trying to get her to the point where she can get what she deserves. What if she were the star of the drama department?
And hopefully get a drama scholarship.
Right. Wouldn't you say? No one ever criticizes those kids about going for the scholarship. Everyone says the athlete is chasing the false values of the scholarship, playing for the scholarship. Okay, so I hope that comes, that's a bridge you're going to cross when you get there. Well, grandparents. Grandparents, a grandmom on your mom's side, and grandma, grandpa and grandma on your side.
Yes.
What's the reaction to all this stuff?
Ecstatic, crazy. My mom's a baseball nut anyway.
Yeah.
So she is enjoying this.
Yeah. Yeah, well, we're going to have to take a break, but we'll be back. And we will meet one Katie Kenny Frisbie, who will be coming on mom in this situation. So all your moms, this will be for you.
My name is Terry Sullivan. This is the Inside Corner, and the topic this evening is a boys baseball pioneer, none other than Riley Frisbie, freshman at Lyons Township High School. This is Channel 99. Don't go away. We'll be right back.
To order a DVD copy of any LTTV program, call us at 708-579-6407 or log on to our website at lttvonline.com. Follow the directions and submit your order. LTTV, welcome home.
Hey, thanks for coming back, everyone. My name is Terry Sullivan, and this is the Inside Corner. We happen to be at Blueberry Hill Cafe, Breakfast Cafe at LaGrange Road and Harris Street. We've been here several times, only because of the generosity of Chris Manolis, the owner. Thanks, Chris, if you get to see this. And the topic this evening is none other than Riley Frisbie. Oh, what's her notoriety? Well, her notoriety is in the historic category. Here's why. She is the first girl ever to make the boys' baseball team at Lyons Township High School. Keep in mind now that the baseball program at Lyons Township High School is a prestigious program. It may be, at this point in time, the best high school baseball program in Illinois. And we have a girl member of that program. She's a freshman and has made the cut, as they say. I went out to see this, just to check things out, you know, to see if this was for real. And I have to tell you, she's better than most of the boys on the freshman baseball team. Now, if the other fathers are out there watching that, that's too bad, all right? Because I don't blow my horn, but what's my credibility in that category is that I see a lot of baseball. I do it for a living, and I'm telling you right now, she has more upside and potential in the sport than some of the boys that are out for the team. But God bless all the kids on that team. They're going to do very well. They have been doing very well there at LT for quite a while now. So we have asked her mom, one Katie Frisbie, to come on and give the mother's perspective on having a daughter who will be playing with the boys at Lyons Township High School. And not only that, but once again, please, the point is she has a daughter who is qualified to play with the boys. It is not a token effort or some publicity stunt or some effort on the part of the high school to show how benevolent they are and charitable that they're gonna let a girl play too. No. This is a person who has made the team because she deserves to be on the team and is probably going to be one of the better players on the team. So, Katie, you're in a very unusual position, really. And it's you know, not that baseball is so important. It's just that she has ventured into a setting where she's the first one ever, and then it's been dominated by males, by boys, all these years. There's a lot of implication to having this girl in an all-boys setting, don't you agree? I mean,
sure.
It's not the norm, is it?
Right.
It's
to her
time.
It is.
Yeah, right. See, there's the point. The kids are much more resilient than we are. We look at this as astonishing and very unusual. But she, Riley doesn't. Maybe that's her supreme confidence. So you went to Canada.
Yes.
You traveled to Canada with her travel team in an all-girls baseball tournament in Nova Scotia.
Yes.
And you ran into other mothers.
Yes.
Okay. And I have to think maybe those were the first other mothers, other than the ones on your team, the all-girls team. So now you're seeing mothers from all over North America. Were they different than you?
No, because in Canada it was more accepted that girls play baseball because they really don't have a lot of softball teams there.
Yeah.
Their high schools have girls baseball teams.
Really?
Yes.
Yeah. I'm learning that. I never knew that.
Yeah. So it was pretty much the norm.
Wow. See, the Canadians are much more normal than we are. It's been our suspicion, but they are much more normal than you. So I have never known that.
Mm-hmm.
Girls are playing baseball in the high schools in Canada. Wow. Okay, so therefore, the mothers are far more adjusted to this thing.
Oh, definitely. Yeah.
They're not breaking the ice and being the first ones and all that.
Right.
So did they give you any advice? Any of them say, hey,
They didn't realize. Do you feel they realized what you were going through?
They didn't understand what we were going through. You know, what do you mean you're the only team? Because we're the only team from U.S. to come there. It took how many girls from all over the place just to get one team.
So they marveled at that.
Definitely.
Did anyone express understanding of how this can be uncomfortable for you back in our area? Did they understand that? No.
No.
See, it's a different culture.
Yeah.
Isn't that something? A different culture.
They'll see it. They're going to come here, I guess, this summer, so they'll see it.
Oh, they are. Mm-hmm. Oh, they will, yeah. The type will take some of those harassments. Hey, did you see girls there who you thought were better than you?
Yes. There's some that are really good.
Really advanced, huh? Mm-hmm. But they were and they were older.
Yeah, they're 17 or 18 years old.
Again, on your team, you were one of the younger ones on your team?
I was the second youngest.
So, of course, they're better than you are. The ones I asked you about, because they're older. Mm-hmm. You know, they've been around the game longer. Did you have the feeling you'd like to go stay up there and play up there?
Yes.
Yeah.
I definitely felt like I could compete with them. They were really good, but they're still at the same, level as my team was. So.
Well, I have the impression your mom and dad have a reasonable attitude that they're not going to allow you to go to Canada and live. No.
That's not happening.
So you can forget that. Yeah. Yeah. Now, did you have a point of realization like Sean did, like Dad did, where you watched her in activities and said...
Oh, she'd always followed Shane around. She was always the back girl, and but I think T-ball, when she started playing T-ball, she was the only one that had the full gear on and was really into it. And in T-ball, you would hit the ball and only be able to go one base.
Yeah.
And finally, by the end of the season, parents were letting her go three bases because she was hitting it so far.
Yeah.
And I think that's when...
That's when you said, uh-oh.
Yeah, we're in trouble.
Yeah, you're in trouble, yeah. Was it... Again, it's... I think what I'm trying to get you to admit to is that when you saw that moment... You felt as though you had more parental responsibility now. Was that the feeling?
Probably.
Yeah.
I just knew I was in for a lot more.
I think. That's what I meant.
Yeah.
So, yeah. I'm in for it now because I've got this extra now because I have to have her. I have to allow her to meet her potentials.
Oh, definitely.
Yeah. So what if she? What if she goes forward with this adulty and never plays softball?
Whatever she's comfortable playing is what she's going to be playing. Yeah. As long as she's comfortable where she is and she's doing well, then why not stay where she is?
I think you're going to have, when this freshman season starts up and you're out there watching these games and you begin to meet some of these other mothers, I'm wondering what kind of a greeting you're going to get.
Normally, I don't sit in the stands.
Yeah.
I'm out in the field taking pictures and I stay off away from all that.
Okay.
Yeah.
So, the others will want to know how did this ever happen and what did you do to make it happen, as though you had a special formula. Mm. Yeah. Were you an athlete?
No.
Anybody in your family ever an athlete?
We grew up with sports.
Yeah. So how did this happen?
It's a Frisbee side. As much as my dad would like to think, some of it was his basketball was his end, but the baseball was all Frisbee, for sure.
Okay. It's totally possible that one side donated those abilities. Yeah, that's totally possible. But there's no doubt that somewhere in her personality and emotional character, there's got to be part of you.
She gets a lot of the confidence.
See, that's the point. That's the point.
Yes.
Yeah.
And she looks good because, we pick out the outfits together.
So you think your contribution here is, the advanced confidence?
Oh, I think mentally we're kind of on the same page. We sold T-shirts in order to go to those tournaments last year. Very expensive. So we designed a T-shirt, put the logos on the back. We sold them to all of our friends, and it paid for almost half the tournaments. So, little things like that we came up with stuff together. We're on the same page.
Do you see these girls anymore, the ones you played with?
See them, but I talk to them still sometimes.
All right, are they spread around the Chicago area or farther than that?
Somewhere, there's five there in Chicago, but there's a lot that are just really
spread
out.
Do you talk to any of the moms?
I talk to the moms because two of the girls also tried out for their high school team. One girl who's made it in the previous years did not make it this year. So she's playing softball. And one of the girls who's also an incoming freshman, Danielle Allen, tried out for her team and she made it.
Which school? Forgotten?
I don't know.
What about the other girls? Do you know any of the high schools?
Oh, there's this girl, Janie Strays. I don't know if she tried out or not, but she was a catcher too.
What school? What high school? That would be so interesting to know. But there are, but are you telling me that on that team, there were other girls who made the boys' baseball team at their high schools?
And they're playing, there are a bunch more that are older that don't live in Illinois that are playing for their high school teams too.
Okay. Yeah, are they varsity level, any of them?
I think so.
Okay. Well, this is great. Congratulations to those high schools and to the girls, of course. Well, so what you were getting to about the T-shirts was, is that you were still participating with her in what parents might call, particularly fathers might call, the feminine aspects.
Sure.
Right?
Sure.
Yeah. So you still do girly things.
We're creative together. Yeah. Yes.
You do girly things.
We scrapbook her stuff and yeah. We do some girly stuff.
Scrapbooking.
I gotta try.
Designing T-shirts.
Right.
And that's probably a healthy balance.
Oh, definitely.
Yeah. Because you don't want her to be all about sports, and I don't think any boy should be all
plus
about sports.
Plus, that gives us time together.
So you're riding with this thing.
Oh,
you're
totally.
You're going with it.
Definitely.
Yeah. You don't think Sean's out of control on this thing?
No. She'll tell me when he's out of control. She'll be like, Mom, come on.
Yeah.
And we'll push him back a little bit.
Yeah. Well, having never played sports, though, so this is your baptism into what this
well,
is.
Well, I played, but I didn't play like she plays, yeah. I mean, grade school and stuff like that, but, yeah.
You never tried out for Little League?
No.
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 And you didn't play at the high school?
No.
Okay, so this is your baptism. You're getting
Definitely.
To see how sharky and competitive it can be.
Definitely.
Yeah.
Well, we saw it with my oldest when he played, so we know we know it's competitive, whether it's there's the one girl on the team or it's just all freshman boys. It's very competitive no matter what, so. She can hold her own.
Do you do girls' nights out, night outs together? Do you shop? Yeah. Do you go to the movies together? Do you?
Sometimes.
Yeah.
Not really like shopping places, more like Sports Authority. But
yeah. People at Finish Line know her by first name, so.
Oh, my God. My God. Are you doing into anything else at LT?
I play basketball.
Yeah. Other than that? Other than sports? Are you going to do anything else? You can take advantage of all those opportunities over there?
Yeah.
Like, gotta find the time.
Like anything. Yeah. I mean, the ecology club, the saddle and spur. Or
no.
No, you won't have time.
No.
You won't have time. Now, when the moms get together on this freshman team, and the boys, predominantly moms of boys, of course, and they want to bring doubleheaders, they want to bring lunch to the doubleheaders. You've done all this before. Because that travel team scene is really gets to be pretty close knit.
Oh, definitely.
So you're not going to be in over your head in regard to what moms feel is their responsibility.
Oh no.
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 Are you going to be embarrassed by this?
No.
No. Because you've already here's the thing: the travel culture has already oriented parents by the time they get to the high school as to how much involvement they're going to have to contribute. So I'm asking dumb questions because, of course, your mom has experienced this. That travel culture is...
you almost have to take a step back.
Yeah, you do.
When you get to high school. And
yeah, you do. Yeah. It's a rest compared to the travel thing. So when you traveled to Canada, you didn't go to Cooperstown?
No.
When you traveled to Canada, you stayed in a motel. Mm-hmm. You had roommates?
Yes.
The first couple of days, because the girls had never played together, so the first couple of days we were there, each of the parents stayed with their kids, just so the girls could get to meet each other. And then once the tournament actually started, then the chaperones were in their room, the parents were off in their own rooms, and the girls all roomed together.
I see. Girls and then the chaperones controlled or managed the girls, and the moms got a breather, or the parents got a good breather.
Mm-hmm.
So you see what your talents have led to. They have created a mini culture that your parents are participating in, like a little society, another system outside the family. It takes a village to raise a child. Yeah, remember this. Remember this before you get involved in any of it. It takes a village, and it's an expensive village. But, you know, that doesn't mean you have to meet anybody's expectations. And the expectations are going to become more and more serious. What would you consider to be a Riley overextended? Just, can you give me an example where you feel she would be overextended, something that you might fear happening to her, like practicing baseball 12 months a year? Where would she be overextended where you would say, wait a minute, she's not having any time to be a girl?
Well, I mean, during basketball season, she was still playing baseball a couple nights a week. She was still going to a trainer a couple days a week and still working out a couple days a week. And at one point it was, all right, let's take a break.
Okay, good. Do you have an enforced study hour at your house or anything?
Yeah, homework is done, right after school.
Right after school.
Yeah, so as soon as you get home, that's when you do it.
And that's a rule. And there are responsibilities at home that you impress upon her?
Oh, yes.
Name one.
That you hate.
Dishwasher.
What, they can't afford a dishwashing machine?
No, we
have
one.
Yeah, but they're so lazy they don't want to empty the dishwasher.
All right. So you have a chore. Mm-hmm. All right, and you have an enforced study hour. And mom has to monitor that. Because this could get out of hand. Mm-hmm. Yeah, remember that. Don't think you're that good. You're good, but don't ever think you're that good. Every day has to be earned. And you've had all these other things that have to balance your life out. Moms usually carry more responsibility, believe it or not, at the lower levels in this baseball thing. Because when you get to be a junior and senior, there's this independence you want. Yeah. And you grab onto it and you start doing some of those things mom did for you. But until then, until that point in time when you're about a junior, the moms are carrying a heavy load because dad's off working. And he'll show up at the games and he'll drive you to the trainer, but it's mom who does everything else in that support system. I think that's the case here. That's what I'm looking at. Yeah. So, do you want this attention for her or not?
I don't know if I want the attention for her.
Well, look
at
this.
I know, but...
Look what I got you into.
I know.
The 9 suburbs is a potential for well over 100,000 people. Maybe if 10% are watching, that's 10%. That's 10,000 people could be knowing Riley Frisbie tonight.
As long as Riley Frisbie is watching what she's doing on the field and nothing that's
exactly
going on outside, then I have no problem.
It's about FUN. Yeah, fun right now. Okay. Hey, we ran out of time. I just finished talking with Katie Frisbie, who happens to be pioneer Riley Frisbee's mom, the first girl ever in the history of Lyons Township High School, 120 years, to make the boys' baseball team. My name is Terry Sullivan. This has been the Inside Corner. My thanks to Blueberry Hill for housing us, to Chris Dorsano, who was an engineer for me this evening, David Carafa, engineer, to Aaron Best on camera, Jake Magorovic, floor director, Andrea Sims, tech director, and my director tonight, one Steve Sullivan, no relation, thank God for him. I'll be right home, Dolly, all right? Please, I promise. Come back and see us again, Channel 99 LTTV.